Why programs might use all the memory in your computer. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I got some time ago. Is it true that the more memory your computer has, the more memory some programs use? I've read several forums where people mention that they have multiple gigabytes of memory and that Firefox, Quicken, or some other program is using over half of it. They call those programs memory hogs and say their computers slow down. I never see that myself. For example, I run Firefox, and it never uses that much memory. So I have to start out by clarifying, by memory, of course, I'm going to assume you mean RAM. Memory does not refer to disk space, although some people do confuse it. Now, normally, programs don't expand to fill all available RAM. They use what they need, regardless of how much your computer has. Therein lies the source of most memory-related slowdowns. There is an argument that one and only one program might benefit from using all the RAM, but only after all other active programs have had their share. I'll discuss what that one program is in a moment. There are lots of reasons you might want multiple gigabytes of memory, but it shouldn't be for something as simple as Firefox. I agree that someone's a memory hog in that situation, but it might not be Firefox. Your experience, everything working fine with relatively low memory usage, is actually much more common. So, how does a good program use memory? Well, a well-written program doesn't pay much attention to the available memory. Instead, it uses the memory it needs and no more. It also releases memory for use by other programs when it's no longer needed. That's an oversimplified definition of a program that's a good citizen. If a good citizen program uses a lot of memory, there's a reason. And most times the reason is performance. Games are a good example. If written properly, a game can keep information in memory for significantly faster access than if it had to read that information from disk. Other programs can take advantage of additional memory in the same way. Database programs like Quicken are a good example. A large Quicken database can use a lot of memory. How Windows handles memory. Most operating systems allow programs to request and use more RAM than is present. For example, a program can request, say, 8 gigabytes of memory from Windows. And Windows could grant that request, even on a system that has less than 8 gigabytes of memory available, or even less than 8 gigabytes of memory installed. How's that even possible, right? The program doesn't have direct access to RAM that doesn't exist. Instead, Windows notices when a program tries to use this non-existent memory. Windows then shuffles things around, moving some of what's in RAM to disk and reading back from disk some of what used to be in RAM. This whole very complicated process is what's called virtual memory, using some space on the hard disk to make it function like there's more RAM than there actually is. The problem with virtual memory, of course, is that disks are slow. No matter what type of disk you have, it's always going to be slower than RAM. If your computer runs out of RAM because programs are requesting more RAM than exists, the system will get slower as Windows reads and writes virtual memory to and from the disk. In the worst case, this can bring the system to a near standstill as it enters what we call thrashing. So let's look at these scenarios that can cause your system to thrash. Reason number one, a program accidentally uses all available memory. The most common case of an application using too much memory is called a memory leak. Remember earlier I said that a good citizen program frees memory for use by other programs when it's no longer needed. A memory leak happens when a program loses track. It just doesn't keep track of the memory that it's used, and therefore it neglects to free it for use by others. Ultimately, it's a bug in that program. Now, in the cases you've heard about, I don't suspect Firefox. While it could have a bug, as far as I know, it's well-behaved of late. More likely, and this is true for actually almost all browsers, more likely is that one of the add-ons or the extensions installed has a problem. Or, even worse, malware of some sort is present. Unfortunately, browser add-ons are a common source of bugs and memory issues, as is malware. Windows tries to manage memory leaks. If a program isn't using all the memory it requested, Windows might very well swap the contents out to virtual memory and the paging file on disk to free it up for use by other applications. However, since there's a maximum size for the paging file, eventually this just delays the problem until the paging file fills up. And again, even before the programs use up all of virtual memory, a memory leak or other high memory use scenario could absolutely cause your system to run significantly more slowly. Reason number two, you might cause all available memory to be used. Programs themselves aren't the only culprits. It could be you. The number one reason well-behaved software ends up using all available RAM is pretty simple. Either you're trying to run too many programs at the same time, or you're trying to do too much with the programs you're running. Now, first one, pretty obvious, right? If you run several programs simultaneously, they all need some RAM. If the total RAM requested is more than you have installed, Windows could move to using virtual memory, slowing your system down. Solution is simple. When you're done with a program, exit it. When a program exits, by definition, it releases all the memory it had in use, even the memory it lost track of. The second situation is a little less obvious, but since web browsers are actually a fairly common cause, I will use Firefox as the example. How many tabs do you keep open? As I record this, I've got something like a dozen tabs open, each on a different web page. Each tab causes the browser to use more memory. If you open enough tabs, your computer will eventually run out of RAM and start using virtual memory. Not only browsers operate this way, almost any significant program varies its need for RAM based on what you do. Opening multiple documents in a word processing program or multiple photos in a photo editor, even the size of the files you're working with can all affect a program's need for and use of RAM. Reason number three, your installed programs might cause all available memory to be used. We've already seen that running too many programs can cause all of your computer's RAM to be used. Unfortunately, there's a good chance you're already running more programs than you think you are. Many programs, unfortunately, many, many programs, install auto start items. These are theoretically small programs that are set up to run automatically either when you boot your computer or when you sign in. If there are many of those, each with its own requirement for some amount of RAM, they could affect the amount of RAM that's left over for the programs you choose to run yourself. Now, auto start programs aren't inherently bad. Much of Windows itself is, in a sense, one big auto start program, and many of its features are implemented as programs and services that start automatically. That's as it should be. Many programs require some auto start component and thus some ongoing RAM usage. Programs like your anti-malware tools, software firewalls, OneDrive, Dropbox, and others, they all provide important functionality that relies on running in the background and using some RAM at all times. Some programs install what many feel are unnecessary components that auto start, and these are the ones that annoy me the most. They use resources like RAM for no real benefit. Now, unfortunately, there's no list that I can give you of what's safe to remove from your auto start. It depends on the programs you use and how you use them. What's a waste of resources for one person might be a valuable feature for someone else. Now, I mentioned that there is one program that might legitimately always use all of RAM. I actually haven't seen this in practice. I'm kind of surprised, but it's true for some operating systems. Let's say you have 16 gigabytes of RAM, and as you run your system, only 8 gigabytes is actively being used by the programs you're running. That means you've got another 8 gigabytes sitting there, available and unused. The operating system could put it to use. It might use it for file and program caching or other internal operations, but it's possible that by putting this unused RAM to use, the operating system could make better use of all resources to operate better. So, if it's available, why not use it for something productive? So, theoretically, the operating system could use all available RAM as long as it knows to step aside when a running program needs more. So why would you want more memory than the programs you use require? Well, there are a couple of reasons. Windows does use memory to better handle its operations, such as reading and writing files to disk. In fact, adding memory to a slow system is one of the best ways to improve Windows performance. Windows is a multitasking operating system, and as you've seen, you can run more than one program at a time. As I write this, I've got several programs running, including my browser with several tabs open, a text editor, a music player, a couple of virtual machines running other copies of Windows, and a few other things. Process Explorer tells me that I've got 424 processes running right now that are using 48 gigabytes of RAM. The more memory there is, the less impact all these running programs have on each other's performance. So, bottom line, watch your memory usage. Task Manager and tools like Process Explorer can tell you not only how much is being used, but which programs are using it. And if it makes sense, consider adding more RAM to your system, if you can. As I like to tell people, Windows loves RAM. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/2548. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.